422-5467. You can also email me at Doug at thedougshoreshow.com. I think we figured out what the little issue that we had. Let's keep our fingers crossed with the technical side of things. I think we got it figured out. Today is a Woman Wednesday. We're paying homage to the great Ashanti today. We dedicate today's show to Ashanti. Ashanti wrote and sang background on Jennifer Lopez's Ain't It Funny on the Murder Remix, which reached number one on Billboard Hot 100, which was also a top 10 in the same time as Foolish, Always on Time with Ja Rule. I like that Ja Rule song with Ashanti. Let's see if we can try to find that. And What's Love with Fat Joe. Later that year, she was acclaimed as the princess of hip-hop and R&B during the early 2000s by her label and capped off her successful debut by winning 8 Billboard Awards and 2 American Music Awards. Throughout her career, Ashanti has sold over 15 million records worldwide. Today, we dedicate the show to Ashanti. Ashanti. Ashanti, Ashanti. This chick fine. And if you've noticed lately, I guess she's in this health kick or whatever. And so she's always online taking pictures in bathing suits or whatever, man, showing off them cakes. And she got much, much cakes. Yes, sir. Stop booing. I like cakes. Stop booing. But also, NFL ratings are down. I don't know if you've seen this, man, but an average of 15 million people watch games for the first 6 weeks of the year, compared to 16.2 million through week six of last season. That's right. Through 6 weeks, 7 games, ESPN's Monday Night Football viewership is averaging 11.2 million viewers, a 6% increase, though, through week six compared with last year. Compared with the first weeks of the 2015 season, NFL ratings are off 18.7%, a sharp drop, but a smaller decline when considering the general overall fall in television viewership due to people dropping their cable packages. You see what's going on here. Last year, the NFL attributed part of the viewership decline during the first 9 weeks of the season for competition from the presidential election, where we were getting firsthand view of punk-ass Donald Trump. And so that's what they attributed to last year. But I want to back up to that whole thing about people dropping their cable packages, man. That's what it is. You remember it was a big storyline. I talked about it for several weeks on how I was getting ready to drop my cable and go full streaming. And I have done that. And I haven't looked back. And I have saved a significant amount of money doing it. And it just makes all the sense in the world. I mean, all of the millions of channels that they have on cable. Now, listen, don't get it twisted. I do have a basic cable package, because if you don't have a basic cable package, you can't get some of the main networks like, you know, ABC, CBS, and NBC. And so because sports comes in those channels, I had to get a basic package. But if I weren't a sports fan, I wouldn't even have that. Like, if you're a person that just watches movies or TV shows or series or something like that, you Gucci with Netflix or Sling or what's the thing that they have? It's the thing where you play video games on. I can't think of the name of it right now. But they got all these different little, you know, companies and streaming companies out there that you can watch TV. And once again, if you don't watch sports, ESPN and, you know, Fox, they got like a real hold on viewers, where their particular networks and stations are like, you know, they're the big cost that's involved with getting a different package. And so they have these different levels of packages, man, and they basically swindling you. If you're a sports fan, you have to get this elevated level of package so to see your sports. But I mean, in time, I think a lot of that's going to be subdued as well. And you're going to be able to get more and more with less and less. You know how it is with new technology. When it first comes out, you know, VCRs, when they first came out, they were $400, $500. And by the time of the end of the VCR run, you can get a VCR for $30 or something like that. And so that's what I think is going to happen with this technology as well, man. But that's the big thing about it. People aren't watching TV, and so they don't have the ratings in the same manner that you used to have. So it's going more and more. It's like a seesaw. It's going more and more with streaming TV and less in regular cable and traditional TV. So I think that's what more so about. And then also, you do have people protesting. You do have people that support, or I guess on the opposite side of the protest in this country, that are mad because NFL players are protesting the flag. And then you also have black people that are protesting, people that are in support of the protest. You also have a lot of those people, that segment of society, protesting because of the unfair treatment of Colin Kaepernick. And so you hitting it from both sides. I don't know how much that is in that 7% that they talked about, but you do kind of have the perfect storm where, you know, I don't know how significant it is once again, but you have people on both sides of the whole protest argument not watching football games. So that is part of it. Cornelia Small in the chat room. Cornelia Small in the chat room says, Doug, it's Woman Wednesday. If Ron Jeremy and Mr. Marcus are famous celebrities, let's stop right there. I don't consider Ron Jeremy, Mr. Marcus, whoever these people are, as celebrities. What? I'm not going to put Ron Jeremy. I think I know who that guy is. I'm not sure exactly who he is. I'm not going to put any of these porn stars in the same conversation with Denzel Washington and Morgan Freeman, anybody like that. Right. So he's referring, talking about, let me finish reading the actual post. He says, Doug, if it's Woman's Wednesday and Ron Jeremy and Mr. Marcus are famous celebrities, then Bust Down Betty can be famous too. That's what that chick name is in that profile pic that I said she don't qualify as a celebrity? Bust Down Betty? Really? from LD from the D Grip. Taraji ain't got no booty, man. She is lacking a booty, but she props it up just right. So it kind of looks like she does. From Al Thompson, I hope she uses the microwave when he plays Kelly, Keisha, and Mary J. I don't know what you're talking about, sir. We have a couple of tracks that we routinely play every Wednesday because the Stewies and the Stewiettes, they request them weekly. Tiffany Poole in Portland. I'm feeling good about DraftKings this week. That's the problem why I keep getting my ass kicked. It's because I don't set my team. I don't put any research in until like 20 minutes before the damn game starts. I tell you what I'm going to do. This week, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. I'm not making no excuses. I shouldn't even have said that shit I just said just now. This week, I'm going to put some real thought into DraftKings. I'm coming for y'all ninjas this week. Bust Down Betty. What kind of damn name is Bust Down Betty for a porn star? Oh, man. That's funny. Bust Down Betty. Charles June B 77 Anthony. Good morning, sir. Looks like a new name in the chat room on the Doug Stewart Show. He says, didn't Ja Rule or Irv Gotti hit that? I'm pretty sure a lot of them dudes may have hit that, but that's fine. I mean, as long as she don't tell me, I'm fine with it. Keep that to herself. From Loose Neck Side. God, bro. Man, we've been doing Woman Wednesday for a long time. The listeners love Woman Wednesday. I'm going to make a proclamation here. I'm going to make an astounding statement here. This picture that Loose Neck Side has as his profile pic may be the greatest one.
Stay right there. This is street music, so it stays right here. No high rock. I'm hip hop.
AKA your girl DY.
Freak rapper, stand down and stay right there. This is street music.
I touch it and it's blessed.
In walks the girl with her hair all woolly. Flow on, swole the unexpected bully. I am not what you thought. Body suckers for sport. And slaughter the ones I caught. Recorded and then report. Yeah. I'm a star, but I rock my day-to-day, yeah. Just so you don't fear me when you see me trying to play fair. My abilities are my greatest advantage. On my worst days, delivery is very hard to manage. At your best, you don't even come close. Who are you? I don't even got the energy to argue. I'm tired of hearing whack bars like those. Please know, you're dealing with a star and life's closed. So I don't rock for free, so stop it. Pull out your wallet, this is not a non-profit. Started out in Jackie Robinson. Elementary, now I'm rocking with legends. This is real black history.
No high rock, I'm hip hop.
AKA your girl DY.
Freak rapper, stand down and stay right there. This is street music, so it stays right here.
No, hey,
no, 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 no high rock, I'm hip hop.
AKA your girl DY.
Freak rapper, stand down. Listen. And stay right there. This is street music.
I touch it and it's blessed.
Up to a minute till you get it before you realize that I'm really here to win it. They say I smile a lot for a menace. You're an afterthought, I'm the premise. I'm real, you're an image. This is only the beginning, and I'm connecting with legends. Truth is,